There were definitely some things on this hunt that I did wrong. One is that moment right before you shoot, right? You're pulled back, you've practiced all year long, you are ready to go. That last second before you squeeze the trigger and release your arrow, have something in your mind that's preset, right? That you say to yourself, whether it's pick a hair and say a prayer, or aim small, miss small, right? Whatever it is, have something set to where that's your practice thing to do. And when you practice, you do it. And therefore, in the heat of the moment, you make a good shot. I know that I'm not super stable. I know that I shake a little bit. I know when I'm trying to hold still, it's not super still. So I know that I have to be careful that in just at that 30-yard shot, right? Just a little bit of a movement can change my arrow spot from, 2 inches behind the leg line to 5-6 inches behind the leg line. And that's what happened this time. It just got away from me. I didn't take that extra second, right? In the moment, in the heat of the moment, to really make sure where exactly my arrow was gonna go. I found him, it worked out, but it's definitely not a mistake you would normally make. The next wrong that I did was when you lose blood and you have to cold trail your buck, right? Which is a terrible feeling as it is to have to cold trail. Look for a dead rabbit. One of the guys who was with us was telling me that. He said, first, when you can't find it, you look for a dead rabbit. Then if you can't find it, you look for a dead mouse. All of a sudden, my eyes like tuned in. When you're looking for a dead rabbit, it's the same color as a deer, right? You all of a sudden are looking like under a lot smaller things, under little bushes, whatever it is. Oh my gosh, you see so much more. It was such a great tactic that I wasn't using, or I've not used before. So when you're looking cold trail, look for a dead rabbit, and if you don't find your deer, look for a dead mouse. The last thing I should have done differently, I should have waited a little longer. So you see on the video, he came right in and I shot right away once I first had the shot. And a lot of people do that. I should have waited a little longer. I should have calmed down a little bit more and just nestled in my shot there. He wasn't spooked. I wasn't worried about him winded me. Some people say, well, you did fine. I would have liked to have made a better shot. And I think if I would have taken just a couple seconds longer, really calmed myself down, really aimed in well, I think I could have made a better shot and then been able to harvest him that night as opposed to the next morning. So there's definitely things I did wrong on this trip. There's no doubt about it. Always be able to learn from your mistakes. Go back, no matter even if you have a success, grab those mistakes, make them better, grow from them, and make a better hunt, make a better hunter out of yourself for next time. So the first tip that I would say is make your property a sanctuary. In Ohio, we can hunt over bait. If you're hunting in other states where you're making food plots and whatnot, make your place a sanctuary. Sanctuary means you don't go in there very often. Our properties are very small that we hunt on, so we don't go in very often. When I touch a bait station or whatever it is, it's no more than every third day or fourth day. I don't go in a lot. I go in the same trail and same out. I don't go in the wind's wrong. I don't go in there and make a lot of noise. I sneak in and sneak out, even if it's just dropping bait, even if it's early season or late season. The least invasive you can be, the better. So make them little sanctuaries and really let the deer feel safe there. And that's what happened with this one, and he came out in daylight. The second tip I would say is stand placement. So many guys are using either stands that are really visible to deer. They say, well, I've had it out there forever. Yeah, but the big bucks know they're there. They don't put up with it the same way. When you think about stand placement, you want to think about height. You want to think about being high enough that deer can't casually just look up at you. You want to think about the camo around it. Stand where the deer are going to stand and look up at your stand. Do you see, right? Do you see the outline of your body? Also the camo you're wearing. I wear one that's got white inlaid in it, so when they look up, it breaks up the outline with the sky. You can do that, you can use whatever camo you want, but make sure that your stand is placed between two trees. I was put in a split of a tree, and it worked well because I had branches on either side of me, and although the leaves are gone, it still broke up my outline, I see, and he didn't see me at all. The last tip that I would say for this hunt was the bait station. So we start our base stations, especially because we're hunting on smaller properties. This is our only chance to get consistent mature deer on the property and to stay there. We start our base stations early in the year. You have to be consistent. Keep those bait stations consistent. Keep them full, keep them protected. Don't hunt when the wind's wrong. Don't ruin your bait station. Don't take boots that are gonna leave scent in there. Don't go in there and mess around a lot. Make them early, keep them full often, and don't go in there very much. When you're putting the bait station, make sure you're putting it in a place where the deer are gonna naturally come. To an extent, in a small property, you're forced to put them certain places. But really, really try to key in on where you're putting it for the different deer. I've got some bait stations that work really well for does, some that work really well for bucks. It's about where you put them, in the woods, out in the field, in a travel way, over on the side, at the base of a hill, so where the bucks come around. It's all what you wanna kill and where you wanna kill it. But you have to be conscientious about where you're putting your bait station. This is a huge one, the feed that you're using. A lot of guys use feeders. I started using feeders. I made feeders. But I have not had the success that I had until I started just putting it on the ground. The big bucks are very particular. Does don't care. The little ones, the little bucks, they'll eat anything. You could literally sit there for 3 hours with your hand open and they'd eat out of it. You've got to be careful with these big mature bucks. They're very picky. You may get one that gets used to a feeder, that'll come into a feeder. But your normal big bucks, if you lay it on the ground, you don't have any man-made stuff around, you spread it out. We use corn, we just use shell corn or corn on the cob, they last a little bit longer. But we have seen 9 times out of 10, the bigger mature bucks like it better when it's just spread on the ground as opposed to coming out of a feeder. You can spray paint the feeder, you can color it all you want. I'm just telling you right now, our experience has been to put it on the ground and to keep it consistent, and those big bucks will come and they'll like it and they'll remember it and they'll come back and hopefully give you a shot. So these have been the rights and the wrongs of this hunt in particular. Hopefully you can take some of these things to make yourself more successful.